All right. Hello, and welcome to another Expert Insight interview. My name is John Golden from Sales Pop, online sales magazine, and Pipeliner CRM, joining you as usual from San Diego. And today I'm joined by Jane M. Powers, who is in a rather toasty Phoenix right now. How are you doing, Jane?
Staying cool.
Staying cool. Indoors, as you can see, with the air conditioning on, I'm sure. And Jane is uses her straightforward, big-hearted style to guide thousands to transform their messages to money from any platform with her speak-to-profit formula and core communication system. And we're going to talk today about speaking with confidence, selling with authority, including the intromercial formula. So let's get straight into it, Jane. First of all, just starting with just speaking with confidence, right? This is something that really a lot of people struggle with. I mean, they may have the background, they may have the experience, the skills, the talent, all that, but articulating it in public is a real struggle.
Yeah. The first thing I recommend, get an accent like yours. Everyone listens to someone with an accent that you, it's just like.
Yeah, exactly. It mine's complete. People. Mine's completely fake. I just adopted it a while ago.
I try to do an accent and it's never consistent. So I'm like, I just have to give it up. I have to go back to my roots of Chicago. So every once in a while you're here, Chicago. So for those of you who don't know me, again, I'm Jane Powers, and I'm going to demonstrate, as I normally do, with my intromercial, because what that does is it eliminates that's an exaggeration. 60% of your fear of speaking, what you do goes away when you have the right message. So most people are afraid because what if they forget what they're going to say? What if they say something stupid? What if they aren't good enough, aren't worthy, whatever the case may be? When you have the right message, you can't go wrong. I mean, literally, the only way you go wrong, John, you know this, is to be boring. If you are boring, the audience will not forgive you. So I'm Jane Powers. Entrepreneurs hire me to speak with confidence and sell with authority, because most are boring, confusing, and inconsistent, and they are not articulating to their ideal audience. So I help them connect, capture, and close their ideal audience. Bottom line, every time you open your mouth, you must make money. And most people aren't. So that is my patented, trademark, registered intromercial, because most people will say, I help. And now you just sound like a volunteer.
Yeah. I think the problem is, Jane, you probably find this, is a lot of people, when they start to introduce themselves, or they start to speak, they start to sound apologetic. It's like, I'm almost like, hello, I'm kind of sorry that I'm interrupting your day, even though you asked me to come and speak to you. I hope you find something interesting in what I'm saying. But it always seems to start off from a position of apology almost.
Yeah, either that or a talking at you perspective. Mm-hmm. So here's what you're going to learn today. I'm going to educate you with, you know, I've thrown into my message the kitchen sink. I went to the neighbors and I got their kitchen sink. So I'm going to give you everything I possibly can in the 3 minutes I have. And people are going to do one of two things. One, they are going to say, excellent, I don't need you. You gave me everything. Or they're going to freeze. They'll be a deer in headlights because that's way too much. I'm overwhelmed. And then they'll go out and try your stuff that you dumped all the information you could and it fails. And then guess whose fault it is? Well, it's yours, because your system doesn't work. So most of the time, it is from the other one, my other favorite, I hope you like me kind of a speaker, where they're like, man, I hope you like me and I need your approval. And if you get one heckler, you're dead. Like you're just done. And truly it's about memorizing. Yeah. People will have 4,000 talks. One talk, one intromercial, one message, memorize the heck out of it. That's it.
Yeah. And then if you do that, then you obviously can, you can use that then to be able to work on your presentation, your delivery, you know, bringing some action into it, bringing some excitement level into it. But you can't do that unless you've done the foundational work. And I think that's another thing, Jay. I mean, I think you hit the nail on the head too, is that people don't know what their mess, sometimes don't know what their message are, or have taken it from somewhere else, or have just written it, you know, typed it, written it down and learned it, but never even delivered it to someone else, or even said, you know, if I said this to you, even to their significant other, let me do my introduction to you. And they'd be saying, oh my God, I'd divorce you tomorrow if that was you for real.
or they introduce, like, you know, this, you've all done this, yeah. You go, they introduce you. And then like 5 minutes later, you're like, you guess at what they do. You're like, or the next meeting, you're going, well, I thought you were a publisher. Why did I think that? Because their message is just skewed. And it's nobody's fault. It's, we try to be a copycat. So we're like, ooh, you know, John said this, I'm going to use that. That's a good one. But it's not you. Like, it's got to authentically be you, or people are going to see through that and they're going to feel that. So, you know, somebody asked me, so my intromercial used to be, entrepreneurs hire me to unleash the world-class speaker in them. And then I get to the final line. So I help speak with confidence, sell with authority, which is the title of my book, Shameless Seed. It probably, you go to Amazon, I probably pay you to buy the book at this point. So when somebody said that, I said, speak with confidence and sell with authority. And they're like, oh, you do sales training? And I'm like, oh, no. That's really all I do. I do it through messaging and authentic conversations. So I took Speak with Confidence, popped it up to the top, and downplayed the speaker coaching, because we're always selling. I mean, you walk into a room, it's almost like you should have the feeling you're wearing a sandwich board that has all of your offering on there. Like, that's how you are as an entrepreneur.
And what you, and to be like that, then, as we said earlier, number one, you have to know your, you know your product, know your service, have something to say, but you also have to believe in it, because we'll go back to authenticity, right? You can't speak with confidence unless you really believe in what you are saying. So I think that's another thing. Sometimes people try to fake it or try to, but you have to take a step back and say, do I actually believe in what I'm talking about? Because if I do, then I should be able to deliver it with some level of enthusiasm.
Yeah, and you yourself should be leaning in and going, I want to buy that program. I want that. And I, you know, I talk a lot. I've done sales corporate training. I mean, I've sales teams, you name it, for the last 30 years, I've done sales training. And it's interesting that it's all the same. Doesn't matter if you own your business or you work for a sales team or you're a realtor. That was a huge industry I worked in, is, you know, the real estate market. And I tell you, you've got to know you and how you operate, but you also have to know the habits, the values, the traits of your ideal audience, of your ideal prospect. So whether it's a one-on-one sales presentation, you're in a boardroom, you have a presentation. Like, people are like, oh, I'm not a public speaker. Yeah, me neither. I'm a sales machine. Like, that's all there is to it. You speak so that you can sell. And if you're not speaking to where people can hear you, if you are inundating with data and stats and, you know, droning on, and your purpose is to educate and hope they buy, well, there's no, I put it this way, you got to be poking the bruise.
Yeah.
I mean, I'm not saying punch the bruise.
Yeah. Although, you know, occasionally, but, but yeah, to your point there, though, which is a really good one, is that not only do you have to be your authentic self and all that, but you have to understand your audience. So as you said, if you're going to do a speech or presentation or whatever it is, to a room full of accountants, then yeah, maybe lots of numbers and stats and stuff is maybe perfect for that. But otherwise, you have to figure out, you know, is it an analytical person? Are they just the top line, high level people? So you've got to paint pictures in the clouds or whatever. But that's a really important part. And then if they're a mixture, then you have the challenge of making sure that you cater to everybody.
I love that. That's where it's all. And I'm telling you, audience, he did not get paid to lead into this transition. But what a beautiful transition. So. Based on the fact I've been speaking professionally over 30 years, I've been doing sales training the same amount of time, plus I've been active in the sales world. So I created, I ripped off every personality profile on planet Earth, put it into the Science of Jane, and I came up with core communication. And core communication is four basic individuals that we run into. And what I do is I make sure, who do you want to work with? Catalyst, optimizer, relator, or expert? Like, if you, I have one client, she's like, I only want catalysts. Catalysts are action takers. I'm like, I don't want a relator. They want warm fuzzy. I'm not warm fuzzy. So everything, the speaking, the messaging that we create for her, it speaks only to catalyst. And so you're exactly right. I'll stand from stage and I'll identify the four individuals where they're always grouped. You know, catalysts are always in the back causing trouble. Optimizers are in front taking notes. Relators are spread throughout because they love everybody. Experts are usually over here. So you address them accordingly. And it's the same with one-on-one. You find out who that individual is. And I'm not saying, remember the old days where you're like, mimic what they're doing. No, this is about saying, I understand your language as an expert or a relator or whichever. I understand how you hear and how you bring in the information and how you assimilate the information. So I'm going to communicate to you that way. It's not a manipulation. It's honoring. If I go south of the border, I go down to Mexico and I'm like, no, speak English. Well, that's rude. So we're trying to do that with our prospects. Like, no, speak my language. And we've got to speak their language to say, this is this right for you or not?
Yeah, you should try that in Paris and you'll soon discover that nobody will, that you'll have a very quiet time there. Should we say that? Because they will not compromise if you make no effort.
Yes, I agree.
Yeah, but it's great. But it is an it's an excellent point, though, because that's the other part is, you know, you've got to be speaking in a language that the other person understands and in the way that they like to receive language. Just like we said a moment ago, if you start putting charts and graphs up to for people who are real, like 30, 50,000 feet people who just want the picture, you're going to lose them really quickly. If you just go 15,000 feet with the analytical people, they're going to not trust you.
Absolutely. It is absolutely. And I love, you know, the best to close are catalysts because they're action takers. They have a gut feeling. And you're not like, so on a scale of 1 to 10, they're like, don't waste that. Just say, are we doing this or not? Like, do it. We're done. Like, it's quick. It's down. It's dirty. It's easy. But you've got to, no matter what, you've got to gain that trust and gain the credibility. And my biggest thing is, no matter what you're doing in your messaging, you can't be ordinary. Like, you can't be ordinary. You can't sound like everyone else. You can't, you know, enter a room and hope, you know, hope you stand out. You've got to find a way to stand out. What makes you different? What makes your value proposition has got to be unique.
Yeah. So what do you say, Jane, then, to the folks, and particularly there's been a lot more of them, obviously, over the time of the pandemic, who've had to end up doing a lot more things virtually, had to sell virtually, do meetings virtually. And I mean, surprisingly, some people who excel in face-to-face have struggled with the virtual, you know, they struggle even with the camera. And you put them in a room full of people, they love it. You put them in front of a webcam, they're like, whoa, what's this? I look like that. I do. So how have you helped people? Because that's not going to go away. So you're still going to have to be able to deliver your message and stand out and be different through a virtual environment.
Yeah. And a lot of that comes from, I remember back in, and I've been doing sales a long time. We had paper systems. Nothing was done over the phone. Like, I literally went building to building. I was in the Chicagoland area. I went building to building, dodging security, no solicitation. I've done it all. I've cried. I've gotten hit by falling glass. That got me a lot of sales. I wouldn't recommend it, but it got me a lot of sales. And I remember when we went more towards using the phone, and I thought, oh my God, I can't see the person. I can't see if they're like rolling their eyes. I can't get their vibe. I don't know what's happening. So I had to train to listen a lot better than observe. And a lot of us are observers. We'll watch and we'll go, I think that meant this. Body language speaks volumes. So I had to listen at a deeper level. And then when it came to Zoom, it went back to listening and being able to see. But I'm going to tell you, I have been on more stages in front of an audience of one to one, I don't even know, probably tens of thousands. And I remember when I first started doing video, I had these crazy eyes. I don't know what my eyes were doing. They'd go up and they'd go around and I'd be like, I'd watch video and I go, what am I looking at? Like, where are those eyes going? And it would drive me crazy. I watched enough video of myself that I went, okay, go back to the basics. Memorize what you're saying and memorize what it is the outcome, the desired outcome is. The other trick is, here's a nice trick. It works for a lot of my beginners. I have them take pictures of their ideal clients and put it right up next to their camera. So that they can be speaking to their ideal client and feeling. Now, I've been doing it so long, it's like, you just know who's out there listening. And the right people are going to hear you. The ones who aren't that into you, it's okay too. But it is about overcoming, getting on video, getting on enough Zoom calls, presenting. But I'm going to tell you, having the right message and memorizing that message is epic. That's the only way to go. And you have to have a wow factor. John, you got to have a wow factor. You probably have seen this 100 million times. People get on, hi, thanks, John. Appreciate you having me here. Love your audience. Love you. Love everyone. There's enough time for that. Like, have a wow factor. Be unexpected. Don't be unprofessional, but be unexpected. Have a quote. You see how I did it with John. I'm like, what you need to do is get an accent. That was unexpected. People were like, oh, interesting.
Yeah, I wasn't expecting my fake accent to get called out.
It worked.
But here's the thing. I totally agree with you. But here's the thing, right, is that there's probably even more onus on you as a seller or as anybody who uses, who has to use Zoom to interact with people is, let's face it, everybody's got Zoom fatigue. The person you're calling, the people who attended the meeting are probably bored with doing Zoom meeting. So it's up to you to put the energy and excitement into it because they're not going to.
Yeah. It's funny when I listen to recordings of, you know, I review and take snippets out and make micro content out of all the trainings. I'm like, oh, for God's sake, why am I always yelling? And I'll tell you why. Because when you are on Zoom, people are multitasking. I don't care. They're like, no, I'm listening. No, you're not. You can't multitask. I know you're not. And what's happening is, you've got to up your energy on stage. You can keep it to a 10. When you are online, you got to be at a 20, but you've got to mix it up and you've got to pace differently. But there's a lot that you can do on, and people are sick of Zoom. And, you know, we have some people are like, okay, stand up, stretch. I don't want to stand up and stretch. Get this thing over with. Like, don't make me move, play a fun game with me. I'll do that. Don't make me get up and stretch and do a little jig. I'm just not that person. So you got to know your audience.
Yeah, I know. I've seen that. I'll give you a funny just example of knowing your audience, right? Is as you can tell, my accent isn't fake. I'm actually really from Ireland originally. But I came to the US during the .com working for an Irish company back in Ireland that was the development center at the time. And the first time we had somebody from the sales and marketing team, one of the American VPs came over to address the development center in Ireland. And at the end, you know, he had the end of his speech, he goes, hey, everybody here is doing a fantastic job. He goes, give yourselves a round of applause. Come on, everybody. And everybody's sitting there going, do what now? Applaud ourselves? Are you kidding? Nobody does that. And so he was left standing there with an audience where maybe you got one polite person clapping. And then he had to go, oh, okay, I guess you guys don't do that here or whatever. But it was a funny reminder of learning about your audience in advance, because it had been a decent speech up to them, but it just bombed at the end because he didn't know his audience.
You brought up early on accountants, CPAs. I was invited to speak at a conference and it was going to be accountants, CPAs, tax, money. And I thought, oh, this is going to be dreadful. No offense, but you know, we're talking numbers. I'm telling you, the way that I opened, because I thought I better know this audience. I've got to pull them out. So I did. Somebody called it a rap. I call it a ditty because I'm not a rapper. But I created this. You got to know it before you show it. You got to do the audit before you bought it. Like, I did this entire rap that addressed each position that was in that audience. I didn't even get all the way through it, and they were standing up cheering. If you can wow them in 3 minutes, under 3 minutes, you could talk about pickles. It does not matter. You've won them over, and because you're speaking their language. I spoke at Inns of Courts, which is a bunch of attorneys, another very exciting audience. And I started out by comparing it to TV shows. And I'm like, I'm so excited that you guys high five after you litigate. And I'm like, this is so amazing. And I could see them all getting like, this woman is so off. And I'm like, all right, you people, please don't break my heart and tell me this is not like, and I named the show, and it was this goofy law show. And they were just like, after that, I had the entire audience. You've got to find a way to capture the audience. And that's the intromercial. So intromercial impact, if your people can go there, intromercialimpact.com. What that does is in 17.5 seconds, it nails your intro. It doesn't say I help. It starts off with whomever hires me, shows you have a viable business. And I'm gonna tell you, you get a 17.5 second intromercial and somebody says you have a minute. That's like, I mean, they may as well give me a keynote speech. A minute? Do you know what you can do in a minute if you have that rehearsed? It's like, but people don't plan. They're like, I'm going to wing it. If you wing it, your audience is going to wing it. And that means they're going to be all over the place and they are not going to take action.
Yeah, and I think that's a great point and a great place to finish up on here, because I totally agree with you that if you're not prepared for your, whether it's a call with one person, whether it's a call with five people, whether it's a presentation to 20 or 100 or 1,000, if you haven't prepared, you don't know your audience and you haven't figured out how you're going to start even, you're basically outsourcing it to fate at that stage.
Hope and a prayer does not make profit.
exactly. Well, listen, Jane, this has been fantastic. All of Jane's information will be below this video, links to her website, her books and all that good stuff. But before we go, I mean, you've already done it, but you might as well finish off again and tell us what you do and how you do it.
So entrepreneurs hire me to speak with confidence and sell with authority. The best way you can do that is wow them, position yourself as the expert and position your audience in their pain so that they understand they need you and you showcase that you're the expert. There's no two ways about it. You must gain credibility in order to move people into action.
Yeah, fantastic. And I think it's such a great piece of advice. So I would really encourage people to go check out Jane's website and her offerings. Again, listen, thanks very much for today, Jane.
My
name is John Golden. Yeah, absolutely. Mine too. My name is John Golden, Sales Pop Online Sales Magazine, Pipeliner CRM. See you all again soon.